So what exactly is the Monster Trio? I'm gonna try to keep this as straightforward as possible, but the Monster Trio is a concept popular amongst the One Piece fanbase, which is basically a way to name the three strongest characters in the Straw Hat Pirates. But what if there was a Monster Trio in Lookism? Now it's easy for one to rush to the comments and say that Lookism's Monster Trio would obviously be Daniel, Vasco and Zack, but I think it's more important that we take a look at each one of these characters just a little deeper, because it might not end up being this trio, you never know. The way I'm gonna do this is by taking a look at the character traits of every member of the Monster Trio in One Piece in order to match those characters to their counterparts in the Lookism verse, as I think this would make this as unique as possible. First of all, Luffy. Well, to begin with, Luffy is probably the dumbest character in all of fiction. He's generally good-hearted, and he doesn't really like to commit evil at all, but this should not be taken for granted, as Luffy's most distinct character trait is that he will chase you down and probably end up whooping your ass if you mess with any of his friends. And he also really likes food. So which character in the Lookism verse would probably be the best comparison to someone like Luffy? I think this member of the Monster Trio is gonna be one of the easier, more obvious options to pick out, and my answer to this question would have to be Vasco. I think Vasco fits the perfect spot for the first member of the Monster Trio for a lot of reasons. To begin with, he is the character who shares the most character traits with Luffy throughout the entirety of Lookism. Not only is Vasco one of the dumber characters in the series, and I mean he's really dumb, like this dude was practically useless during the arc where we needed Koji to step in to help us find God Dog, but he also almost got a restraining order once whilst trying to riz up a fucking blind date. I'd say the only character trait Vasco doesn't necessarily share with Luffy is how much he eats every day, but practically no one other than maybe Logan Lee would share that with Luffy, and even then that would be a stretch if you know what I'm saying. It becomes pretty clear to us throughout the storyline of Lookism that Vasco actually possesses the same distinct character trait as Luffy, and that is that he will protect his friends no matter what. He's a very good-hearted person, just like Luffy. He had a tough upbringing, just like Luffy, and has created a crew which is dedicated to bringing down evil forces while simultaneously chasing his dream of surpassing Go. He will generally let it slide if you were to talk about him in a mean or nasty way, but this would never be the case if said wrongdoings were committed against any of his friends, especially if they're amongst the burn knuckles. I mean, this dude was literally crying tears of blood when his right-hand man and best friend got hurt by a member of the Ants on Public. So yeah, it's safe to say I think Vasco is probably the most obvious counterpart for Luffy in Lookism's Monster Trio. Now, the second member of the Monster Trio is probably gonna be straying away from the main cast a little bit, as we're trying to find a Lookism character who resembles Zoro. Now, Zoro is a character who is intensely loyal to the people around him, especially his captain. He's always seen taking the pain for Luffy, and he always respects any decision Luffy makes without any hint of doubt, except for when said decision is not in favor of the Straw Hat's own good. He's also extremely devoted to the dream of becoming the world's greatest swordsman, and he generally spends most of his time either weightlifting or sleeping and getting some rest, so he can wake up and lift some more weights. Now, it certainly is quite difficult to find a character in the Lookism verse who could necessarily be regarded as a counterpart for Zoro, as he possesses a wide variety of character traits which make him unique in a seemingly irreplicable sense. I mean, there simply isn't any character out there in all of fiction who is as bad at following directions as Zoro is. However, if I had to pick a character trait that made Zoro stand out the most, it would probably end up being his loyalty. And this presents us with two options left to choose from the Lookism verse. Either it's Jay or it's Jerry. Now for Jay, though he's loyal to his best friend Daniel, I don't think it would be necessarily right to call him more loyal than someone like Jerry. This is because I think Jerry and Jake's relationship has a much deeper meaning behind it than that of Jay and Daniel. For example, Jay and Jake have known each other since a young age, and their relationship stems much deeper than that of Daniel and Jay, because it starts even before any of the two got involved in acts known as gangism. This is similar to Luffy and Zoro's relationship in One Piece, as they were the starting two in the Straw Hat Pirates, and they knew each other even before any of them were strong. I mean, not only is Jerry's title in Big D literally the Sword of Jake Kim, but his father also shared the same title in Gapyong's Fist, and Baiko and Gapyong shared the same sort of loyal relationship with each other ever since the pre-generation. And although showing reluctance at first when he was a kid, Jerry's loyalty for Jake Kim grew stronger as the two got older, and he even constantly visited him in jail from the information we were given so far. So yeah, for Zoro's counterpart, I've decided to pick Jerry. However, feel free to share your opinions in the comment section on who you think would be a potential counterpart for Zoro and Lookism's Monster Trio. Again, these guys don't necessarily have to be associated with each other, they just have to share the same character traits as their counterparts in One Piece. Now finally, we have Sanji's counterpart. Now Sanji, first and foremost, is the biggest simp in all of One Piece. This is probably his most emphasized and distinguishing characteristic throughout the series, as there's almost never an episode where he doesn't simp for Anami or Robin, or practically any other hot woman in the show. In addition to that, Sanji had probably one of the toughest, if not the toughest, upbringing and backstory out of every character in One Piece. He was abandoned by his parents and everyone around him and was left with practically nobody to look out for him. He usually remains calm when rough situations are on the horizon, and he tries to make sure that most of his crewmates are safe at all times, especially the women. Now, it seems as though Sanji is represented by a multitude of characters throughout Lookism's story. His backstory is replicated by someone like Johan, for example, but I think the only valid pick, in my opinion, for a character which could resemble Sanji in Lookism is Zack Lee. It's quite obvious that Zack is the biggest simp in Lookism. The only real difference between him and Sanji is that Sanji continued simping even after he got immensely powerful. However, the reason behind this is the fact that the characters he simps for still play a major role in the series. On the other hand, a character like Mira I doubt we've seen in the past 50 chapters, or maybe even 100. Zack was made to believe for a long time when he was younger that Johan was simply just better than him, in a similar manner that Sanji was always humiliated by characters like his brothers. However, both Zack and Sanji were able to overcome their limits and eventually surpass these characters. Which is still arguable for Zack, but anyway. However, I think Zack still shares the most character traits with Sanji out of anyone else in the Lookism verse, in my opinion. So it seems like the monster trio was quite close to what you would have imagined at first. However, it seems like Daniel doesn't do the best job at resembling either member of the monster trio in One Piece. Anyway, share your opinions in the comments. As always, I'm gonna read them all. And before you go, if you'd like to see another monster trio video, but this time for actual powerful characters in Lookism, then just let me know by leaving a like on the video. Anyway, see you all next time.